So he came into office basically claiming he was going to become the great disruptor. But the reality is he's pivoted since he entered office to become a relatively traditional, so far, curator of the U.S.-China relationship.
What about in terms of North Korea? In a recent op-ed, it came out earlier in April, you argue that China is suddenly leaning on North Korea, and it might be thanks to President Trump. You wrote this, quote, "Something interesting is happening in China, and perhaps President Trump deserves some credit." Now, I know a lot has changed since you wrote that, but do you think Trump, in his first 100 days, has succeeded in getting China to finally rein in North Korea?
I think the Chinese have been increasingly irritated with North Korea. And Trump has, over the course of the last several weeks, really pushed them to come to the conclusion that perhaps supporting the North Korean regime no longer is beneficial to China's interests. In addition, North Korea's regime is acting increasingly belligerent. And so from that perspective, I think the combination of North Korea's trajectory, their increasing belligerence, and Trump arguing that if the Chinese don't really begin to help out more, the U.S. could cause China a lot of problems with secondary sanctions and a variety of other issues. The Chinese are concluding that perhaps it's time to really put pressure on the North Koreans. This is a work in progress, though. It's a work in progress.
But I got to ask you about trade, because Trump just made that U-turn on NAFTA. He now says he wants to mend it, to renegotiate it, not end it. And that kind of brings us to the TPP. That he did scrap early on in his presidency. What does that mean for China? Has that turned into an opportunity for China, an ever-rising and ever-prosperous China?
So by removing the United States from the Trans-Pacific Partnership on his first day of office, Trump did more than several of his predecessors in the White House to help China in Asia and to actually bolster China's power and influence in Asia. Because the Trans-Pacific Partnership was, for better or worse, no matter what you think about what it would do for American workers, it was a trade agreement that joined together almost all of America's friends and allies in the region. And by removing the United States from that conversation, you effectively cede to China the future of trade relations and economic relations in Asia for foreseeable future. So it was a huge self-goal by the United States.
A self-goal, because on his first day of office, scrapping the TPP, it was a huge boost for future prospects for China and its business ahead. The One China policy, Trump had publicly challenged it. He questioned it. He had that phone call with the Taiwan president, Tsai Ing-wen. Trump later, he agreed to honor One China and has again signaled that he will continue to do that. But what's the view among the Chinese? Do they trust him? Do they think that President Trump will continue to honor the One China principle?
I think they're taking him for the time being at his word. But again, like the trade issue, the One China issue has shown Trump to be the guy who's pivoting 180 degrees away from his original policy, which was to throw into question the One China policy. The reality, though, the question is Trump offering to soften U.S. policy towards Taiwan in exchange for more Chinese help on North Korea? Trump, in his transactional way, his sort of let's make a deal approach to foreign policy, could clearly put Taiwan on the trading block, if you will, if the Chinese play ball on North Korea with more aggression, and something the U.S. would like to see.
So Donald Trump, at the end of the day, he has pivoted on different issues. He is not so far the great disruptor after all. What is going to happen next? I mean, as you write in your book, the relationship between these two countries has been there since the founding of the American Republic. This is a very deep relationship. What's your thinking on the future of the relationship as Trump continues his term in office?
And right now, if you look at his China team, it's extremely thin. Dozens of people who would normally be involved in the creation of China policy are just not working yet. And so he has an extremely thin bench looking at China. And that's not to the long-term benefit of the United States. The second thing is the Chinese respect power. And they also they want predictability. And being the great disruptor is running at loggerheads with the Chinese desire for predictability in their relations with the United States. And that's another issue. And finally, the Chinese are very sensitive to American presidents who make demands and threats and then don't carry them out. They will end up looking at a person like that as what the Chinese say, a paper tiger. And Trump, in his bluster and bumptiousness, needs to make sure that if he says he's going to do something, he's got to go.